Russia has released expert findings showing that a chemical attack in Syria was apparently conducted by the rebels and not the regime. The assault in question killed dozens of people near the city of Aleppo back in March. The report comes as the U.S. strives to convince the world that Syria's opposition has no access to chemical weapons. RTC Group Piskunov reports.
This is a detailed 100-page long report which provides thorough analysis of the weapons which were used in that attack in Aleppo in mid-March. And first of all, it concludes that it was in fact a chemical attack. The weapons which were used were custom-made and were similar to the ones usually used by the al-Nusra, one of the most radical rebel groups with links to al-Qaeda fighting against President Assad's regime. Investigators also found traces of hexagon, which was used to release the chemicals. That is not the way it's done in the military. And also they found traces of the sarin nerve gas, which was produced not industrially but was homemade, and found traces of another chemical which was used by Western nations in the times of the Second World War. So these are the main arguments presented in this report, which do suggest that that attack in Aleppo, the chemical attack, was in fact conducted by Syrian rebels. This is actually the second time that we're hearing about this report. Russia already passed it over to the Secretary General of the United Nations back in July, but neither then or now we are actually hearing about it in international media. Basically, de facto, this report is being ignored both by world powers and international media, unlike the three reports published just recently on the recent attack near Damascus. They were presented by the intelligence services of the US, Britain, and the UK, and all three suggest that that was a chemical attack which was conducted by Syrian authorities. A lot of media attention is currently being paid to these reports. Basically, they are in international spotlight, even though one of the key arguments in all three is that, they are based on interceptions of communications, satellite footage, and open source reports, which are actually YouTube videos and information from other social networks. The how correct it is raising lots of questions. And another argument shared by all three intelligence services, pointing that it was the regime which held that attack, is that the rebels, the Syrian rebels, are simply incapable of dealing with chemical weapons, something which is not proved, it's not confirmed in the report presented by Russia.
Well, we talked to the UN veteran and its former humanitarian coordinator for Iraq, Hans-Christoph Graf von Spanak, who explained why Russia's findings are largely being ignored by the international community.
You can ask that question on a range of other reports that have been received, which are not convenient for those who are determined to carry out an attack. But we cannot avoid looking into this, and the media have an obligation also to shed light on this when there are rumors that Saudis and Qataris have supplied chemicals. Is that true? I don't know. That the Israelis were involved in this, let there be a broad-based presentation. What I would say about is that the stalemate that prevails in the UN Security Council, I say this because I'm a person who has 32 years worked in that organization, the stalemate has been created by the insistence of the P3, France, Britain, and the United States, that the only answer to a crime whose origin we don't even know yet must be military action.
And in the U.S., Obama's push for a strike on Syria has passed the first hurdle after the Senate committee voted in favor of the resolution. The U.S. Secretary of State also pitched the case to the House of Representatives. One reason for an attack that Kerry cited was to prevent U.S. allies in the Gulf states from increasing their support to al-Qaeda cells within the Syrian opposition, which they might do in desperation to topple Assad. Defense analyst and author Ivan Elin says this rhetoric does not stand up to scrutiny.
That's implicit blackmail, and I don't really think it's, really a conditional thing. I think they'll probably do it anyway, and I don't see how U.S. bombing would stop that. In fact, as I say, it may cause the jihadists even more to be more active in the war simply because the U.S. is attacking an Islamic country. They're actively trying to alter the situation on the battlefield against Assad. But on the other side, you have al-Qaeda, and I think al-Qaeda might even be worse than Assad. And also, we're slowly getting dragged into this war, if you're trying not to get embroiled in a war, because then you're implicitly taking one side over the other, even more so than if you're just bombing them to say you shouldn't have used chemical weapons. And I think then you get a stake in the outcome of the war.